doing The Cave of the Forgotten Dreams. Has a disc.
There's a disc inside the box.
Nothing else special. So the film is about caves. It's about Werner Herzog going into some caves.
Back in 1994, two researchers stumbled across this cave on mere coincidence by feeling air pressures coming through the cracks. Upon researching the cave, they discovered cave paintings dating back 32,000 years, which is twice as long as any other cave paintings that have been discovered.
Usually we talk about the movie and then we talk about the 3D as a separate layer of the movie, and I don't think we can do that with this one. I think the 3D is such a part of the story and point, really, of this film that they're very much intertwined.
When I first heard about this film, a film about cave paintings in 3D, I thought it was incredibly stupid. I thought, why would you want to watch a painting in 3D? I see why he did that now, because you actually go down inside the cave, you feel like you're there, you can see how the paintings use the space and warp around the space within the cave.
You get to see depictions of prehistoric creatures in action. Many of them are in action.
So much of the film is just the experience of being there, which you can't do. You can't just go there.
They were saying at one point it had to be closed because of the breath of the people that were in the cave was causing mold. So just like literally breathing is ruining the cave. The 3D is crazy intense.
It was all shot with a GoPro rig, which are these like little cameras that people use for sport stuff like skateboarding and surfing and skydiving. The cameras themselves aren't very good compared to your normal film production cameras. So in that respect, it was not good. It's really intense, the way they shot it. The space is very small, so they didn't have a lot of time to... And they were also limited with the time they had to be in there, so they didn't have a whole lot of time to compose shots well for 3D.
Well, they weren't even allowed much equipment using... They had, like, three cold flat lights. And then they did describe the equipment. It was very, very minimal.
With only a crew of like four people.
They only had four people. So, I mean, they couldn't have done any better.
There are a lot of bad cuts in this too for 3D, jumping from like extreme amounts of depth things.
To extreme sunlight.
That too, going from really bright to really dark and vice versa. And going from a shot of like a deep cave through and then a guy popping out right in front of you.
Speaking to the structure of the film, that was something I was surprised about. You didn't spend the entire time in the cave, which I think worked because it let your eyes and brain like take a break from just the intensity of the cave and the stories and just contemplating on the real scope of what it is that they found. When you think this kind of material is going to be hands-off documentary style. Like, we're here to capture and, you know, basically, you know, not package it too much and just give it to you. But it was really personal.
Everything he does is personal, baby.
If you just want something that will force you to, and give you time to, contemplate on the complexities of life and how living in this world today, your spirit's connected with someone, you know, 30,000 years ago, and just how we're all one man.
Are we today the reptiles, the albino crocodiles that stare deeply into the abyss?
Are we now the crocodiles of the future?
Are we just their mirror image? The Blu-ray itself contains only English audio for this U.S. release. It has English and Spanish subtitles, no French.
En español.
It has two special features. One is a trailer, the other one is a 40-minute behind-the-scenes look at the making of the music.
Kind of boring.
It really boring.
Yeah.
I would give the film a thumb up, despite some 3D issues. It's a really strong film overall. This Blu-ray release of it, meh, you could do better.
I'm against it. No, I really liked it. a lot, actually, and I thought the 3D was pretty cool. Like, parts of it was like, it was unnecessarily too cool, if that makes any sense. But I think it was really good.
I'm gonna echo Ryan's response of solid outing. But yeah, I don't know, the Blu-ray's like, well, that's this a is the format. Yeah, it's like, this is the format we're going to deliver this to you in.
Film worth watching.
If yeah, definitely.
Have like a 3D on demand channel that has this, I would say watch it over there. We're buying the Blu-ray, download it, you know, something.
No.
I mean, don't download
no.
it.
No.
Right.
Buy it. Buy you it. Wouldn't download a car, would you?
If I could get a 3D printer to print out a car, yeah, get lost in this. The cave of forgotten dreams.
Rotten dreams.